this time?
Bring in the French chap who got out last night. Together he's roughed up a little.
He didn't make it then. What went wrong?
Took him out of the railway station, apparently. We'll have to tidy him up before they stick him in the cooler.
Oh, I can do that.
That's my job, George.
We have a patient for you, Doctor. Lieutenant Bougirard decided to broaden his horizons. Unwisely, as I keep on reminding you all. I give you 15 minutes, Doctor.
15 Uhr will ich ihn wieder haben. How far do you get, Bougirard?
Where they nab you?
Shut up, you lot. I got work to do.
Well, keep still, Lieutenant. What did this? Rifle butt?
We.
Ah! Sorry, old man. Open, right? Yep. Yeah.
Yeah, it'll be a bit painful for a while, but otherwise there's no harm done.
You're lucky, I've actually got some sticking plaster. Jerry stuff, not much good, but better than old newspaper. George, any antiseptic left?
No, not till next week. Use the last on this idiot.
Never mind, he'll live. Hold that, will you?
Did you hear anything? About the war, I mean.
No. There is still no blackout in the town. Some of the right marks are old issue. No longer in currency. That's how they caught me. Tell your escape people.
Right. All right, you can have him now. Better luck next time.
C'est la chance. Alors, vite! Hep, 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 hep.
It's a boy scout lark, Doc. He didn't have a chance.
Oh, I don't know, George. There's always a chance.
The only certain way is repatriation.
My dear chap, you've got to be half dead before our protecting power can intervene and recommend repatriation. It's not something you can fake.
Not the body, perhaps. But in the mind, it's not so easy to be sure.
Well, fake insanity?
Mm-hmm.
No. Like the average chap just couldn't do it. It would need specialised knowledge. Or just pretending to be Napoleon is not.
Well, I could do it.
What?
When I was at university, I had a part-time job in a mental institution. I know how they behave.
Oh, John.
Why not?
All right. Accepting for a moment you have a chance of pulling it off. You're quite sure you're able to go through with it. Right, I've asked Simon to be in on this, but no one else is to know. Is that quite clear? Not Player, Carrington, anyone. Doc, would you like to fill us in a bit?
Well, I'm not an expert, Pat.
Yeah, but you're all we've got.
Well, I think this would have to be a psychosis situation, rather than neurosis. Otherwise, no trip home. And I suppose, for this exercise, we're basically in the area of schizophrenia.
All right, just keep it simple, will you, Doc?
Well, it's characterized by remoteness, delusions, a pathological fear of persecution. Look, John Donne said, no man is an island. But that's exactly what the schizoid subject is, trying to become.
This could be pretty rough, Wing Commander. You realize that the Swiss may not make an appearance for 6 months.
I realize that. I know what I'm up against.
Oh, George. You have to do this so well. Well, you have to convince me, in a sense. You have to convince the German medical people and the protecting power. I don't say you can't, but... Well, I just wish you wouldn't try.
I've made up my mind. I'd like to have a crack at it.
All right. Well, you know the rules. Good luck.
Thanks.
Wing Commander, just one minute. Well, there is something else. You're going to have to live this for upwards of 6 months, possibly even a year. You're going to live it all day and every day, not just with the Germans, with your fellow officers as well. There can be no let up. Have you realized the possible danger to yourself?
I think so, sir.
I wonder if you have. But once started, I need your word that you'll carry this through, do it thoroughly, right until the end. Before the war is over, we're bound to have one or two genuine mental cases in here, and I'm not going to let any escape attempt ruin the chances of those poor devils being repatriated. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
All right. What are his chances?
Who knows?
Okay. just get out.
You?
You've been a big help in the past.
You know what you're doing? You're just a bloody quack.
Now listen, Marsh.
Stop.
What is happening here, please, Doctor?
I don't want this man in the sick bay, Hartman. If they're still available, I'll ask for the German orderlies I had before.
Will you explain, please?
Well, he's becoming a nuisance. If you ask me, he's going round the bend. And I can't afford to have him assisting in here any longer. He's nearly poisoned a patient. And he goes off into a trance every 5 minutes. Well, you're the guards. You keep him out.
Fine. What is it, Gefreiter?
We have detected the sounds of tunneling, sir.
Tunneling? Huh? Where is it?
It's here, sir.
Hauptmann.
Search commandos to the senior officer's quarters, parcels office, and the floor upstairs. The rest come with me.
I know what you're trying to do, sir, but... Well, you started a search that nearly wrecked the whole setup. Just want you to think what you're doing. It's like talking to yourself.
Oh.
Good night, George.
My senses have handed me this letter. Will you examine it, please? It is from your wing commander, Marsh, presumably to his wife. We have tested it for invisible writing. There's nothing. Your explanation, please.
Do I really have to spell it out for you? It's a simple, obvious psychosis.
Why?
The man has cracked. It's tragic and it's dangerous.
That is all.
Right. Titan. You wish to see me, Major?
Yes, Herr Doctor, I do. It's about one of our men you had occasion to examine recently, Wing Commander Marsh.
Oh, yes. The one they call Tweedledum. Yes, yes, I have examined him 2 days ago.
Then you may well have noticed paranoic symptoms. And there have also been frequent lapses into a semi-catatonic state. I'm very worried about him. And, well, I really came to ask your advice, as I understand you hold rather advanced views on certain manic states, and, well, I'd like to benefit from your obvious knowledge in this field.
But of course, Major. Please sit down.
Diamond lead. Oh, no, not again. Just leave.
Son. Where are you going, Wing Commander?
Out!
But you know that is prohibited. Come back in.
Hello, George. Don't see much of you these days.
Wing Commander is not quite himself, yes?
Yes, it's time he was put away, Admiral.
Perhaps. Perhaps. I brought you out of the paymaster's office into the prison guard because I have a special job for you.
Sir?
I want you to watch this Wing Commander Marsh very closely. Tell me if you think he's faking. He may be trying to put us off guard to effect an escape.
But, sir, what does the doctor think?
The Stabsarzt is convinced that he's genuine. I am not.
Sir, I am not competent to do this. I have no medical training.
You have actual experience, Hartwig. That is more valuable. How is your brother?
He has been removed to the asylum at Heilbronn, sir. His condition has deteriorated.
I see. I'm sorry. Now, I will rely entirely on you, Hartwig.
Sir!
Pack it in. Can't you pick on someone your own size?
I really enjoy this.
Permission refused.
Fight, boys. Oh. Courage. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
So the guy's in Scotland.
Simon. Bad news about Marsh. Just come from the German MO. Commandant's refused permission.
Oh. Well, I'll tell him later. I want to ask your advice about Tweedle. Hmm? Well, he's really becoming a damn nuisance. The chaps are starting to complain. He's making them windy about the new tunnel.
He's bound to get on people's nerves. That's my real worry. It's that Corporal Hartwig, or whatever his name is. He's got it in for George, and he's getting vicious.
No. Now what?
What's all this about?
I don't think Ulmann approves of Wing Commander Marsh.
Ulmann's enjoying this. It's perfectly obvious that Marsh saw his head. Well, damn it, I ought to know. He's in the next bunk.
Wegtreten!
All right, let's have a look at you.
Why don't they put him away, Doc? One day you'll really get hurt.
I'm trying, Dick, but it isn't easy, you know? I'll push off, you know, will you?
I'm putting it off, Marsh. Do you understand that, you cretin? Off, off, off! Get off! Get off! Get off! Get off! Get off!
That light is becoming a real menace.
It's getting dangerous. I never knew you were so strong.
Commander, digging a tunnel, are you?
But it's not the right place, is it? There are too many people around. And the ground is a bit hard, isn't it?
Go and have a little rest in the sick room.
Sent for me, sir.
Sit down, Hartwig.
Sir.
You heard about Wing Commander Marsh?
Sir, I cannot be with him all the time, sir.
Never mind about that, Hartwig. What do you think? You've been watching him for some weeks now, haven't you?
3.5 months, sir.
So? Well, is he crazy or not?
I think the doctor should decide.
Never mind what the doctors say. What do you think?
I'm not sure. At first I was. I was sure he was faking. Good, but faking. It made me very angry. You understand, sir? My brother.
Yes, sir.
It is very difficult. Before they took him away to the asylum, he was very like this man, Marsh. I do not know. Wing Commander Marsh was so like him, but I do not know. He may be very clever.
The Commandant wants a full report. Our doctor recommended a proper examination, which was refused, as you know. Now the Commandant is reconsidering. What do you think?
I think, sir, the doctors should decide.
Dressed up for
no idea.
Well, whoever they are, here they come.
Top brass. Well, I heard Rommel wasn't doing too well. Perhaps we're going to put him in here with us.
Taking him there, Doctor?
To the civilian hospital at Knaschwitz. The Commandant has finally acceded to my request after that exhibition.
Will he get proper psychiatric treatment there?
Oh, he's not going for treatment, Major. He's to be thoroughly examined by Dr. Herzl. If he's found to be truly sick, then the authorities will decide on whether repatriation is possible.
Tweedle's back.
Oh. He's got no hope.
Simon.
Die if that's true. I don't think he's really ill, but I wish to God he'd never started this.
You've nothing to be proud of, Corporal. Please don't vent your spite on my patient in future. He's a very sick man.
If he's not ill in
the accepted sense... I don't want to talk about it, Simon.
I warned you, Marsh! You're gonna smash that record! I'm fed up with that bloody record! Will you...
Brent! Brent! Leave him alone.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning, Corporal Hartley.
You will be pleased to hear that Red Cross parcels will be distributed in 1 hour. Officer of the day. Would you please report to the parcels office to arrange for distribution?
Try and stop me. Wonder what we'll get this time.
Crepe Suzette. Come on.
Wing Commander.
I'll be damned.
Wonder if we've misjudged our corporal.
No, old Tweedle's won him over. He's convinced the most difficult one of the lot. When are the Swiss chaps due?
Not for a couple of months yet. Oh. Can't help feeling uneasy about him.
No. He's doing a thundering good job. Oh, look at him.
start messing about, Tweedle. Come on.
Beautifully up to now, but this is the test. Convince them. Good luck, old man.
Erlaubt, bis einzutreten?
Jawohl, Herr.
This is Wing Commander Marsh. You will find the case history on page 3 of your files, together with our own medical report.
I have given permission for Gefreiter Hartwig to remain with the prisoner during interrogation.
The Wing Commander Marsh. Please, sit up, Wing Commander. We would like to talk to you.
I could have killed him on more than one occasion. I don't mind telling you. But he convinced me. I mean, he convinced all of us. He did an extraordinary...
Hi, Doc.
Hi, Phil. You think Tweedledum is going to make it?
Oh, I think so. You're especially friendly with him?
Well, I can't say that I am. I think we're all happy to get rid of that poor idiot.
I think they'll see where their duty lies.
I hope so.
Hartwig.
Wing Commander, you must come with me now.
George. I take you now. You're going home. Yes?
I'm not going. I live here!
Come along.
Wing Commander.
No!
There's nothing to be afraid of.
No, I won't go!
Sie beide. Nehmen Sie schnell zum Wagen.
Played that right up to the end. Saved the best bit for last. Oh. We're gonna check if everyone's here now we've had visitors.
Of regard for your profession, I've decided to tell you, quite unofficially, of course, that it has been confirmed that Wing Commander Marsh was repatriated. In fact, he arrived in England 4 weeks ago.
Thank you. I'm very glad.
It is not a particularly fitting way for a soldier to return home, of course, but we live in difficult times.
Yes, I understand. I'm very grateful for everything you've done.
Well, I thought you'd like to know. You may continue with your duties.
Doctor, just the man I want to see. Huh? Bossier. You remember Bossier? He was the one who was gone. What Styler? Well, I have something to tell all of you. Come on. Gentlemen, Bossier is free! Just had news, a postcard from Spain.
Oh, that's amazing.
You are all invited to a celebration in our quarters.
Hot Marsh! It's incredible!
Hell of a stroke to pull off.
Well, you certainly fooled me. I damn nearly sorted him out once.
He damn nearly sorted me out once.
You realize we can't tell the others?
Well, they wouldn't believe us anyway.
That's a pity. The French are really going to be smug about Bossier.
Well, maybe, but Marsh's escape has got to be kept between us.
You've got to hand it to him. It's marvelous!
Come on, let's join the French celebration.
Right, yeah.
Gentlemen, I wish to read you a letter that I've just received. It concerns Wing Commander Marsh. Dear Colonel Preston, I'm writing to thank you and the men of Colditz for all you've done for my husband during his imprisonment. You can doubtless imagine what it means to me to have him safe in England. George has now been committed to the Ainsworth Mental Home outside Harrow, so I'm able to visit him quite easily. I'm afraid there is little hope of any improvement. but I take comfort and strength from his own quiet acceptance. Please convey my thanks to his friends and to the German soldier who befriended him. Sincerely, Helen Marsh. Gentlemen, I absolutely forbid any further escape attempt on those lines.